Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. First, I want to say we're on Treaty 6 land, and we appreciate being able to play music and tell stories, and maybe one of the first places that stories were ever told, ever. So I want to thank you guys for coming up. I appreciate that. So I'm the youngest son of the Edmonton Eskimo CFO, great Hall of Famer, Rolly Miles. And yeah, you guys know about his sports accolades, and you know, he's like a Grey Cup champion and all that, but I just want to talk a little bit, like, I was born on his birthday, and like, he's my best friend, and my dad was crazy. Like, he's always pranking. Okay, so we had this game where, I don't know, from the time I was in like grade 5 till I was like in grade 11, whenever we take a shower, we throw cold glasses of water on each other. Like buckets of water, big pasta buckets of water. And then I was like, well, I would just lock the bathroom. But my dad always kept it open. And I'd always get them. I'd always got them, so. It's just crazy, and I want to share this story too. Okay, so I'm a type 1 diabetic, right? And when I found out about this, I also had a swollen thyroid, and I had to have an operation like a year later, right? And I was totally freaked out about everything about that. Like, I hate hospital, all that stuff. What? Okay, so this is how my parents, how crazy my parents are. After my operation, I'm like coming to or whatever, and both my parents are sitting at the edge of my bed going, it's all crooked. I said, what? It's all crooked, your head, they sewed it all crooked. Yeah, that's my dad, all right. All right, so I've also had the pleasure and honor of playing with James Brown, the godfather of soul. He came here in 1983 and I got a chance to play with him and actually got a chance to talk to him one-on-one. Okay, he wanted some pot. But not for him, like I never smoked a joint with him or anything, but I took up the biggest joint ever rolled in my life to him. But I did get a chance to talk to him one-on-one, and he was like, you know, he said, whatever you do, like, try to stay original, try to stay funky, and try to make a name for yourself. So, see how I'm doing. There's just one thing about me I love for. I love funky music, you see. I love the bass. I love the sound. I love the drums and guitar that make you move down. So give it up. Thank you. swearing. My band's fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Fever on guitar. Audio show on trombone. Eric Wine on trumpet. My wife said something to me the other day. She said, you know, nothing is better than getting together with your friends who are bad motherfuckers and playing the music that you wrote. It's true. Unfortunately, yeah. Unfortunately, like, police have been killing black men since I was born. I was born in 1960. Now, social media nowadays makes you think it's like a brand new thing or whatever, but unfortunately, cops in the States have been murdering black men for a long time, and you guys know what's been going on in the news lately, and I just want you to keep that in mind when I tell you this story. Bubba had Woody. Woody came back and had Cassius. Cassius came back and had Rahsaan. Cassius came back and had Mel C. Cassius came back and had Woody. Woody came back and had Sammy. Woody came back and had JP. JP came back this year and had Bunny. Now, I'm looking out my front window. There's three cops out there. They're talking to someone and I'm being nosy. I go outside to see what's going on, right? And I go to sit down and a cop looks at me and gives me that cop vibe of, we'll talk to you in a moment. So I sat my ass down on my front stoop and just waited for them to come over. And then these three cops walked up on me. And right before they said anything, my crow friend JP landed on the arbor and went, oh, oh, oh. Totally froze the three cops. They were like, wow, I've never heard a crow make that sound before. The next 10 minutes was me telling the police officers how I've been like filming crows for like the last 8 years. I wrote a book about them, The Majesty of Crows. And they're just like, they adopted me, and I'm telling the cops that, and I'll tell you guys, like, crows have two languages. They have the loud when they're calling and telling people, we're over here and the food's over here or whatever. And then they have this soft language where they warble at you, and it's just, telling you like I love you or whatever. So I warbled back to JP, and then told the cops that. And then that totally changed the vibe. Right? The cops were like, and I was like, wow, that little big little black birdie, he totally had my back, man. And then oh, it was awesome just to feel that love. It was pretty amazing. And so the cop says to me, so do you know why we're here? And I said, I don't have a freaking clue why you're here. He said, well, neighbor said there's a marijuana smoke in the backyard. And I was like, well, damn, that's definitely me. It's like, I got a medical license. Aren't I supposed to smoke in my own backyard? But that's not it. The story was the amazing love that crow had for me, and he had my back, and I love those birdies.
Thank you.
gotta hold on tight. Because there's something so precious, it simply isn't right now. It's something that comes from a heart that cares, or something so wonderful. Thank you so much. This has been such a dream journey for me, this album. I got some serious writer's block in 2015. Couldn't write a song for the life of me. And then I got this loop machine, a loop app for my iPad. And I did a project where I wrote a loop one a day, my song a day project. And during that project, I realized that some of the songs I looped, just the jams, they were songs. I just made up my bed right then and there. And actually this album, 9 of the songs on this double album are just transcriptions of my loops with real instruments that I played. So it's kind of fun. And this tune is called Good Year. It's one of those songs, one of the loops. And when you buy the disc and I gotta do some marketing. We got t-shirts, Brett Miles t-shirts. We got download cards and these M&Ms, personalized M&Ms. And we also have my old discs. So each thing is for $20, so please leave all your money here with me. It's dangerous in the streets, you shouldn't go home with it. Okay, and on the record, my nephew, Rolly Pemberton, the one and only Cadence Weapon, he raps really nice. You know something too, when your nephew's a rapper, and a really good rapper, he saves all his best stuff for your songs. Oh man, if you listen to every song that Rolly is on, one of mine, all the verses he spits, man, and this one included, it's sublime. Okay, so this is about a good year, because you know, we can have a good year, no matter how much news is bad, and all this stuff, and like, and all that. One of the lines in this, his rap is like, if you want to have a good time, stay off the internet.
Okay.
with your guys' voices, you feel like singing a little bit?
Sure.
I want you all to help me out because it's Dwayne's birthday, man! Such an amazing musicians and like freaking Dwayne, man. You can do anything. Seriously. You need a percussion, you need a drummer. Your vibe player. Alright. So is my sister Mickey here?
Yeah.
Alright.
Your sister?
Yeah, my sister right there. Now, you know, this is like I normally everybody remembers Teddy and the Black Experience and sound, and I got a little story about him, my brother-in-law, and Rolly's father. But I want to talk about my sister Mickey for a second, because she's amazing, and she's probably been to more gigs of mine than maybe I have. Think about that shit. So one thing that I love you so much, Mickey. Thank you for being here. And we're playing this song for you. Something Teddy always did in the show. Always play some Hendrix. We're stepping away from the original right now. We're gonna play some Jimmy for my sister Mickey. Woo. Come on! Two drummers! Oh my God! Next to your fire. You're deep inside the equalizer. Between 88 and 89, everyone's got to have one. 88.5, CJSR. You're deep inside the black experience and sound. Romping and stomping through the city with no pity whatsoever. Like I always say, I got my gorilla suit on today. Stick and stay, don't you ever go away. I'm not gonna let no clone take the throne. You know what I mean? Cause I can't be duplicated, Xerox copied, or duplicated. Cause I'm the one and only, your guy, T-E-D-D. Wow.
Thank you so much. Now we're taking a short pause from the calls. We've got a lot more music and we've got a dance floor. A lot more stuff coming up. Please, put your hands together for Tom Gallo on the bass. Come on, my man, Jamie Felt on guitar. Mo Fever on guitar. Greg Smith on guitar, we call him Sensei. He's a master. Kevin Barrington on the drums. Dwayne Hanek on drums and percussion. Eric Lee on trumpet. Adria Chella on trombone. That was my beautiful wife dancing. She also wrote the lyrics for there. She also wrote the lyrics for love. And me, Brett Miles. Thank you so much for coming out and seeing me. Oh man, it made me feel so good. I really appreciate it. And I really appreciate it if you bought all our merch. We'll take a short 5-minute break for 10, 15 minutes, and we'll see you in half an hour.